So over the last year, we have heard loads about the brand new rumoured M1X 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pro, what's going to replace the current 13-inch MacBook Pro and the 16-inch MacBook Pro. But what makes these new MacBook Pros so special? Well, today I'm going to discuss the reasons why. So at the end of 2020, we got some brand new Macs, and what made them special was the brand new Apple Silicon M1 chipset inside, just like what's inside this 13-inch MacBook Pro that I have right here. However, some of the MacBook Pros, for example, were not replaced with Apple Silicon, like the 16-inch MacBook Pro like I have right here. This is an i9 MacBook Pro, it's the top of the line one you can get right now. And also the top line 13-inch MacBook Pros with Intel chipsets are still for sale as well. Over the last year, we've heard loads of changes that are going to be happening to the design of the MacBook Pros. For example, we're going to be getting a whole load of new ports added or added back into the MacBook line. For example, back in 2015, we had a brand new MacBook, which is known as the MacBook, and it had a USB-C port, just had one port on it. And then when the MacBook Pros came out around about a year later, all we got was USB-C ports all over the MacBooks, just like this 16-inch MacBook Pro here. I've got four USB-C ports. I don't have any SD card slots anymore. I don't have a normal USB port, or for example, I don't even have a HDMI port as well. Also, something else that went missing was the MagSafe connection. But the good news is, guys, there's been some great progress in leaks and reports that we've heard that some of these ports are going to be returning back to the MacBook Pro line. So we have heard that we're going to be getting the MagSafe connection back inside the MacBook Pro. Now, you're probably wondering why MagSafe was taken away in the first place. Now, there's many reasons behind it, but personally, I believe it's due to the actual charging speed. USB-C has phenomenal charging speeds in it, whereas MagSafe was much more slow. It was a slower technology. And as times moved ahead, Apple just couldn't create a MagSafe connection that basically powered up your MacBook Pro or gave it enough battery life fast enough on the go. So they had to use USB-C. And there's nothing wrong with USB-C either. But I think Apple have been working in the background now, and they've managed to make MagSafe work and give really, really fast speeds through it for the next few generations of MacBooks that are going to come out over the next few years. So it's going to be really, really good to see this coming back. Also, the whole thing as well, that many of us with these USB-C ports, if we had to plug in something else, let's say we had to plug in a HDMI connection or if we had an SD card, we had to actually get ourselves a sort of a dongle or a hub to plug into it. And it was all dangling outside of the MacBooks, and it wasn't really comfortable, and we got to use this kind of environment now. Now, I can understand that Apple wants kind of to have a portless environment, but it just seemed really weird, and it just seems a bit odd over the last sort of 4 or 5 years where we've had to just constantly keep on plugging in hubs and dongles, and it's just got really, really annoying. So it does seem like Apple are going to be returning back at least a HDMI port and also returning back an SD card slot as well, because so many people out there, creators like myself who use photography and use, for example, doing video editing, we all use SD cards, and it'd be great to not just plug this into a dongle and then plug this straight into our MacBooks. It'd be great to have this all built in from the go. Now, as much as adding more ports in, something else that looks like it's going to be taken away from the MacBook Pro, and that is the touch bar. Now, the touch bar got introduced on the MacBook Pro lineup back in 2016, and it was Marmite. A lot of people loved the idea of it. I thought it was a really cool idea. And I'll be honest, a lot of other kind of third-party apps jumped on it. So for example, the likes of Adobe, let's say Microsoft Office, and loads of other things as well, like Google Chrome, all use the touch bar what's on the MacBooks, like my 16-inch and also my 13-inch MacBook Pro that I have here. However, I don't think it's been as successful as Apple wanted it to be. Not so many people use the touch bar. I, for one, do use it, and I would say I do use it every day, but I'm not always constantly pressing the buttons on it. And if there are any buttons that I do press on that touch bar, the main ones are to do with the brightness and also to do with sound. And these are the physical buttons that we used to have on the MacBook Pro anyway. So it's looking likely that Apple are probably going to be taking away the touch bar. It's not been as successful as they want it to be. And lots of leaks and reports out there are saying this is going to be coming true. Something else we cannot wait to see, and it's not actually to do with these MacBook Pros, it's to do with the giveaway we are doing on this channel right now. And it's for this iPad Pro. And I'm going to be giving away this iPad Pro, what's got an M1 chipset inside it and a 12.9 inch display, to one lucky subscriber when we get over 260,000 subscribers. And we're not that far away now if you have a look at the subscriber count right now. And all I want to know from you guys in the comments below is, are you planning on getting yourself a brand new MacBook Pro or any Apple gear for the remainder of this year? Let me know in the comments below, and also make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, I'm going to be announcing who the winner is of this iPad Pro M1 12.9 inch model with 256 gigabytes of storage inside it when we hit that amount. And you'll want to get that notification to find out if you're going to be the lucky person getting your hands on this iPad Pro. Well guys, let's continue on talking about these MacBook Pros a little bit more. Another technology that we were introduced to this year was the brand new XDR Retina display, and this was put inside the iPad Pro 12.9 inch model. And now we've been told that the new MacBook Pro 14 inch and the 16 inch new models are going to be getting this screen technology put inside them. Just recently, I got myself a brand new LG TV. In fact, I did a review on this, and it has mini LED technology in it, and it looks absolutely phenomenal. Do check out my video on my channel though about that. Also, I did a review of the iPad Pro 12.9 inch model, and as well, it just looks absolutely incredible, that display. It is absolutely gorgeous. So to have this inside the brand new MacBook Pros is going to be absolutely amazing. So this is something we're definitely going to be looking forward to, and it's going to make something the MacBook Pros even more special. Something else that is most likely going to be put inside all the MacBook Pros is going to be the brand new center stage camera. This has been introduced into most of the iPad range this year, including even the budget 10.2 inch, $329 iPad, and it's very likely this is also going to be put inside the actual MacBook Pros. The MacBook Pros have only had a 720p camera inside them since around about 2011-2012, and they've never been upgraded. We don't even have a 1080p camera. Yes, the M1 MacBook Pro does have the newer engine with that camera, and it sharpens the image a little bit more clearer, but it's still a 720p camera. So it's going to be great to possibly get a 1080p camera, what's also going to be a center stage camera, inside the MacBook Pros. Now the main highlight, what's going to make these MacBook Pros extra special, is got to do with that brand new Apple Silicon chipset what's going to be put inside them. Now a lot of us out there, including myself, keep referring it to the M1X chipset. Now, we're not 100% sure if it's actually going to be called M1X chipset, so don't come back to this video in a few months' time and say, you said it was going to be M1X, and it wasn't. We just don't know, but a lot of us are referring it to M1X, and the main reasons behind this is Apple in the past, with the Apple Silicon chipset, mainly in iPads, have put an X on the end when they bolt on a few more cores for the actual chipset. So for example, I think it was the third generation iPad had an A5X inside it, and this was basically a couple more cores on the actual standard A5 chipset. And then also then in more recent years with the iPad Pro, we had for example the A12X, and again this had a few more additional sort of CPU and graphics cores inside it compared to the standard A12 chipset. And what we believe is going to happen with the new 14-inch and the 16-inch MacBook Pro is we're going to get a few more cores extra special than the standard M1 chipset that we have right now, like in the 13-inch MacBook Pro. We've been told most likely we're going to be getting 2 efficiency cores, and we're also going to be getting 8 performance cores. Right now, M1 has 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. So you can see a massive difference straight away. The Pros, this 14-inch and the 16-inch MacBook Pros, are designed for performance. On top of this as well, the M1 chipset also has a GPU with 8 cores inside it. We've been told that the M1X chipset, or whatever it's going to be called, is going to be having 16 cores or even 32 cores in some cases. Most likely this is going to be dependent on how much RAM you're going to pick, and also, for example, the 32 core option of the GPU might just be exclusive to, say, the 16 inch MacBook Pro. Apple have done this before, where they like make their sort of top tier pro model to have something a bit more extra special inside it. For example, like the iPhone 12 Pro Max last year compared to the iPhone 12 Pro actually had a slightly better camera system inside it compared to the 12 Pro. But then, having said that, this year with the iPhone 13 Pro and the iPhone 13 Pro Max, they are identical, apart from the 13 Pro Max having a slightly bigger battery and obviously a bigger screen. But apart from this, there's no differences. So we're not quite sure what Apple are going to do here. But what it is saying out there in leaks and rumors is that we're definitely going to be getting a 10 core CPU, 2 efficiency cores, 8 performance cores, and then with the GPU, we're going to be getting either a 16 core or 32 core GPU. And this is going to be absolutely amazing, because the performance on that is going to be absolutely leaps and bounds. Right now, for example, the M1 chipset CPU is actually ahead of than this 16 inch MacBook Pro with an i9 chipset inside it. It's actually faster, the CPU, than what's inside this. And so you can imagine with M1X, it's going to completely blow both of these machines away with its performance. And we cannot wait to see that. So there you have it, guys. There's a summary of the brand new 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pro and why these MacBooks are going to be extra special when they come out later on this fall. Well, guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please also do press the subscribe button, followed by the notification bell. Until next time, guys, I'll see you soon.